friends, welcome back to my channel. The recipe I'm going to show you today is one of the most requested videos in my channel. I'm going to show you how to make chicken biryani in pressure cooker. Many of you complain that you don't get the perfect texture and the perfect taste when biryani is made in pressure cooker. I'll give you two important and simple tips that you can follow so that your biryani turns out delicious. Tip number one. When you're making chicken biryani, always remember that the amount of chicken that you take should be a little more than the amount of rice. For example, if you take 1 kg chicken, you should take 3/4 kg of rice and not equal portions of chicken and rice. This will make your biryani really flavorful and tasty. Tip number 2. Some of you complain that you don't get the perfect texture when biryani is made in pressure cooker. To get this right, what you have to do is, once the pressure is released from the cooker, you need to open the cooker and take out the rice immediately after fluffing it up a little. Then press the rice in another bowl for 5 to 10 minutes before serving. When you allow the rice to stay in the pressure cooker itself, the rice will become mushy. It will stick together because the heat is still on and the pressure is still there inside the cooker, especially when you make large quantities in pressure cooker. So it is always better to fluff up the rice immediately after opening the cooker and take out the rice and rest it in another bowl without serving. This will prevent the rice from sticking together. I hope these two tips really helps you in achieving your perfect biryani, the perfect taste and the perfect texture. So now let's get into the recipe and see how I'm making it. Here I am taking 1 kg biryani cut chicken. Whenever you are making biryani, you can ask the shopkeeper to cut it into big chunks of pieces so that it will be very juicy and tasty in the biryani. Now to marinate this, I am going to add 3 tablespoons curd and 1 tablespoon salt. We will also be adding salt while making the chicken curry, so it is enough to add 1 tablespoon salt here. Mix the chicken well with the curd and the salt. Cover the container with a lid and allow it to marinate for 30 minutes. Now let's move on to make the masala for the biryani. To a pressure cooker, add 175 ml oil. Add 1 tablespoon ghee. Do not add too much ghee to biryanis as it will make the rice stick together. Just 1 tablespoon ghee in solid form will be perfect for this recipe. Add 5 green chilies, 2 bay leaves, 5 cardamom, 10 cloves, 1 piece of star anise and 2-inch piece cinnamon stick. Also add 10 peppercorns. Allow the spices to get roasted in the oil ghee mixture until you get a nice aroma. Once you start getting a nice smell from the spices, add 5 big onions thinly sliced. It is important to give enough time for the onions to brown on medium flame. If the onions are not browned properly, you can see them standing separately in the final product, so give them enough time to get browned. While the onions are browning, we'll prepare the rice. Today I'm going to use Basmati Rice Super from the brand India Gate. This pack contains 1 kg plus 250 grams extra, but today I'm going to use only 3/4 kg. So I'm measuring rice in this tall glass and taking 2 glass full. This will approximately make 3/4 kg. Now I have washed this rice twice and then I'm going to soak it in water. Make sure all the rice is soaked in water and keep it aside for 30 minutes. Meanwhile, our onions have beautifully browned. Now I'm gonna add 1 cup mint leaves and 1 cup coriander leaves.
add 3 tablespoons ginger garlic paste. Mix it well and allow it to get fried in the oil for a minute. Now I'm adding 4 sliced tomatoes. To this I'm adding 1 tablespoon salt. Always keep in mind that we have added salt during the marination as well. Allow it to cook in medium flame for some time until the tomatoes turn mushy. Now add 1 tablespoon chili powder. We are not adding any other masala to this biryani except for the chili powder. We can see that all the tomatoes have already turned mushy. If there are any big slices of tomatoes remaining, mash it up completely so that you will not find big chunks of tomatoes in the final biryani. Now I'm adding the marinated chicken to this. Mix it well with the masala. This chicken masala has enough water content to get the chicken cooked nice and soft. So I'm not going to add any water to this, just cover the pressure cooker and allow it to cook for 2 whistles. If you don't like to pressure cook the chicken, you can cook it on medium flame until it turns tender and soft. After 2 whistles, our delicious chicken masala is ready for the biryani. Now it is time to add the soaked rice. I'm going to remove the water added to this rice for soaking. Now the rice is dry, let's look at the amount of water content in the cooker. This amount of chicken gravy contains 3/4 cup of water content in it. So we need another 3 1/4 cups of water for 2 cups of basmati rice. Here I'm measuring and adding 3 1/4 cups of water in the same cup in which I measured the basmati rice. Now we have added the required amount of water, give it a good mix. After adding the water, we can taste and see if the salt and the spice is good enough for us. At this stage, you can add additional salt and chili powder as per your taste. Mix it well and allow the water to come to boil. Now add the soaked and drained rice to the boiling gravy. Add the rice quickly and mix it well. We are now going to add juice from 1/2 lemon. This step prevents the rice from sticking together. Now it is time to pressure cook the biryani. You can cook it for 1 whistle and allow the pressure to release completely before opening the cooker. Since our cooker is almost full, after opening the cooker, fluff up the rice immediately and transfer it to another container to prevent sticking of the rice. Rest it for 10 minutes and now you can see how beautifully our biryani has turned out. You can see that our biryani is not at all dry as seen in some restaurants. It's really moist, soft and well cooked. Do try it out and enjoy a happy meal.